Okay, so basically what you're looking at here is sequences of betting for playing dozens and columns in roulette. In case you're not too familiar with roulette, by dozens I mean play thirds of the field. So first dozen would be 1 through 12, second dozen would be 13 through 24, third dozen would be 25 through 36. Or the three columns, which go up. Basically how this works, and these are set up for different bets, a $3 bet, a $5, $4 bet, $5 bets, and $6 bets. Basically, I wouldn't start playing even on $3, unless you have $114 to start with. At $114, it gives you a 93% chance of getting your money back at minimum, and winning some as well. So how it works is if you start off, play $3 on a dozen, if you hit it, keep playing $3, just keep picking different dozens or stick with the same one, whatever you want to do. The sequences come in if you miss, so if you lose. And by the way, the sequence you're going to do, and this is multiples of your first bet, so every time you lose, say I bet on the first dozen for $3 and it hits in the second dozen, so I lose. I move over in the sequence, now I double my bet, so my $2 bet is now $3 bet is now $6, and if I win, then I go right back to $3, start betting again. If I lose, I move into the next part of the sequence. So now I multiply my bet by three times, I bet $9, so now I'm $18 in, but if I win, the dozens and columns pay 2 to 1, so now it's 27, so I would have just increased my money by $9. So every time you lose, though, you just move your bet up, so that way the probabilities of missing that dozen, every time you go down, the probabilities are lower and lower and lower. So by the time you get down here, what's that, six misses, I think? Yeah, if you get six misses, there's a 10.3% chance that you'll miss again, which means that you have almost a 90% chance that you're going to win your money back there. Once it goes down again, now there's only a 7% chance that it won't hit here. So you have a 93% chance to win your money. Here you get a 95.2%, and your percentages just keep getting better. It's all about how much money you start with, pretty much. For me, I generally start with 114, work my way there. That gives me 7 chances. It gives me a 93% chance of winning my money, which, knowing Vegas, or the casinos in general, those are really good odds. So I'll show you how that works, and I would recommend also that you download a roulette app on your phone. Practice on there first so you don't just waltz right into a casino thinking you're going to win, because, like I said, this isn't guaranteed. So it's that even when you get down to like 97, 98%, that other 2%, 2 or 3% can and will bite you. So, I've got 117 here right now, so I pretty much look over here. This is the cumulative amount you would have spent to get to that part. Highest I can go is 7 times. So, if I've got a 93% chance, but if that 3% chance hits me, I'm done. I can't go past that. I've only got enough to play that far. So, go ahead and try this out. I'll show you how it works. Okay, so I'm going to put a $3 bet on the second dozen, so 13 through 24. See what happens. And I missed it, so I'm going to double my bet, move up to $6. And stay on that second 12. You can't move off of it. You gotta keep staying on that. That's where your the probability chances come in. So just keep betting on the same one, no matter how many times you lose, so long as you can afford to keep doing so. So I missed again, so now I'm going to go to the next part of the sequence, 3 times my bet. So now I bet 9. And remember, I started at 117, so that's what I have to get ahead. So I bet 9. Still betting on 13 through 24. So missed it again. So now I move to the next part of the sequence. Four times my bet, so 12. And you see, it looks like I'm just sitting here losing all my money, but you'll see where the sequencing comes in. And there we go. Now I won. And now I am up to... Oh wait, no. I didn't win. I'm an idiot. Okay, so I didn't win, so now I have to do six times my bet, so now I have to do 18. What I was thinking there. So now 18 times my bet. $18, six times my bet. And now I got it. So now I'm up to 123. And now, because I won, I don't have to follow that sequence. Now I just go back to betting three. Start over again. So I'll go with the third 12. And I missed it, so I would double my bet. And that's basically what you keep doing. Another thing I've had happen that I would mention is that sometimes I'll get up pretty high. I'll get up, I'll say like $250 or so, and I'll start playing, and I'll get all the way down. See, like with 250, I can only play up to right here at 174. So 95.2% chance that I'll keep my money. I have had that other 4.8% chance bite me. So what I've started trying to decide in there is, once I get back down to my original money, like say I'm 114, well, say I was, I guess 250 isn't the best example, so go further up here. So like once I start getting down though to where I'm around my original money, sometimes I'll try to decide if I want to keep playing those odds, or if I just want to take the loss on my winnings and go back to just $3 bet, start over again pretty much. I think starting over is a little safer, but it depends on how lucky you feel, because you still, at that point, say you would have like a 95% chance, but that 5% can bite you. That's pretty much how that works. You just keep doing that. Oh yeah, and as far as increasing your bets, what I would do, you look, like starting at 114, I'm giving myself a 93% chance. So I wouldn't really start moving into the $4 bets until you're at least to $152. So that way you're still keeping yourself in that range, 93%. I would actually, as you move up though, I would stay in here until you get to 232, which will give you a 95.2% chance. And same thing, if you move into the $5 bets, I wouldn't go lower than 190, wouldn't start lower than 190. But I would actually prefer to start with 290, $6 bets, 228. Like I said, I would go with 348, and you just keep doing that all the way up. So, I mean, if you wanted to start off with like $50 bets, if you're a high roller or whatever, you just multiply your bets by the sequence. It's pretty easy to remember. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 13, 20, 30, 45, 67, 100. Yeah, that's just what you multiply your bet by. And like I said, it's an easy way to turn the house's advantage over to your side.